All right, we're going to run through this real quick. I was actually going to do an NBA live stream tonight. I'll scrap it for Friday or Saturday, depending on how the night falls. But giving my top five quarterbacks going into 2018 season. First is Drew Brees. Didn't have a lot of touchdowns last year. They had 23 touchdowns, like 8 interceptions or something like that. Hand the ball off a little bit more, but he still got it, man. It was time to turn on versus Minnesota. You know, he rallied the troops back, and they came back. His arm strength is definitely dipping. But I think he's the fifth best quarterback in the league still. He can play the game on an intellectual level, you know, and he still got enough accuracy. And people don't understand how hard it is being 6 foot and playing the quarterback position, man. Real talk, it's a hard position to play when you about 6 foot, 5'11", or somewhere around there. There ain't a lot of passing lanes to be passed through. And, yeah, Brees is still number five, man. Some I can't get honorable mentions yet, but. There's a few guys that didn't make the list that some people might argue. It's just my opinion. And, but like I said, they went more to a run first team in New Orleans last year. A lot of the passes was to the flat, but he still threw for over 4,000 yards and over 20 touchdowns in a watered down system to preserve his arm and body into a late playoff run And, like I said, towards the end of the game with Minnesota, he turned it on, man. The second half, he still had it. He still had it if it wasn't for Marcus Williams. I think the safety was at 42-43. That went for the weak-ass tackle. And Minnesota won. And next week they got whooped by the Philadelphia Eagles. My number four quarterback is Russell Wilson. Brother Wilson, last name Wilson, whatever you want to call him. He had a phenomenal year last year. He had like 30-something touchdowns and like only 8 interceptions. And it's just not like that. You know, sometimes I thought it was overrated, but I went back to look at his body of work. Sorry, man, I got a lot of allergies today, man. A lot of people complaining. I'm like, fucking, I ain't perfect. But, you know, we go back and look at him, man. He ain't had no offensive line. Wasn't no Marshawn Lynch, Doug Baldwin. I mean, he ain't got the best receivers, you know what I'm saying? A lot of guys like Paul Richardson that can get deep and stuff of that nation. Jimmy Graham just didn't fit in that system. And the defense was still falling apart. You know, Cam Chancellor might have a career-ending neck injury. Cliff Averill might have a career-ending neck injury. Chairman towards Achilles, Bobby Wagner barely was out there, Earl Thomas barely was out there, Sheldon Richardson. I mean, he really ain't show up for real for that defense. And Wilson still performed no matter what running back was, if it was McKissin, if it was whoever was back there in the backfield. Wilson did it, man. He got a good arm. Another guy that's about 6 feet or under, still making the hat and captain, and with nothing around him. He ain't got what Drew Brees got in New Orleans, you know what I'm saying? He ain't got what Roethlisberger got in Pittsburgh. He ain't got what a lot of guys got, and he still performed without the Antonio Browns, without the Le'Veon Bills, without the Ezekiel Elliott, without the Todd Gurley's. You know, he's still performing, and that's to be respected. And he deserved, he earned this spot in my top five. I don't care what y'all say. I can say whoever else better than him. You show me who out here balling like Wilson and got less talent like him as well too, man. He ain't got much around him. My number three guy, man, they shitted on him in the Madden rankings. In my street sharp voice, Carson Walker to and Wentz. You know what I'm saying? For the Cowboys haters, I don't like the Cowboys neither. F your star. I like Carson Wentz. He was balling last year. People forget it. And then you got Skip Bayless putting out false propaganda to Nick Foles. But anybody that watched that team know Carson Wentz is the truth. Man, right? Last year, he diced up that Denver defense. Man, boy hung like 30 points on them in the first half or something like that. I mean, well, nobody stopping them. Even with the Rams. They was going point for point with the Rams. And they still end up winning. When he went out, mobile, out the pocket, he could do it. He had a little hiccup in Seattle this year, but ain't nobody perfect. You know, he was on fire. In my opinion, he should have won MVP. You know, in my opinion, he come back healthy, man. He gonna set the league on fire again. I mean, the way he throw the ball is just beautiful. It's sweet. Deep ball, accuracy, it just whip out his arm. He got the power. He got the mobility. He got the skills. And I see why they picked him that high, man. Carson Wentz is the absolute truth. I'm a huge fan of Carson Wentz. Don't have nothing against the Eagles for real, you know. But like I said, Wentz. It's not comparable to any NFC North quarterback to Wentz. It's not comparable. You know what I'm saying? It's only two quarterbacks that I hold higher in the NFC and the whole NFL. You know, well, in the NFC higher than Carson Wentz on this list. And like I said, man, I watched a lot of Philly games last year. I play FanDuel. I'm an avid daily fantasy player, so I'm always chiming in. And you know, dude is the truth, man. He the truth. You know, may Alshon Jeffries relevant again after being down in Chicago, man. And may Torrey Smith relevant again as well too. But we on to my number two guy. That might be some shocker for people that know me. I'm a Michigan guy, University of Michigan. If you're a Michigan guy, go ahead and subscribe to my page, Motor City Sports Talk. We talk Michigan, Michigan State, and everything Detroit, if you're interested in that. But Tom Brady, Tom terrific. He getting older, man, but he my new number two guy. I got nothing against the Patriots, man. Like Brady, even at Michigan when he was battling with Drew Henson. Like I said, man, he's still playing at a high level. I think it's one bad man in my Stephen A. voice that's better than him right now. And that's to be expected. This dude is 40 years old. He's still good. You know, he still, you know, he thrived without Julian Edelman. And years before and prior to that, he thrived without Gronk. And, you know, it don't matter who at receiver, he going to make it happen, Captain. Who at running back, he going to make it happen, Captain. But to clarify the list, this is for quarterbacks born until 2018 based off their performance last year, not based off a Lifetime Achievement Award. Just to clear that up. And I like Tom Brady at number two. And like I said, man, I think he's going to have an okay year this year. But eventually that injury coming, man. That injury is coming. Or them body aches, his body going to break down. I would have kept Jimmy Garoppolo and probably moved him and gave him a farewell deal and just say, you know, just retire, man. You know, we want to move on unless you want to go somewhere else and stick it to us like Joe Montana tried to with Kansas City. Which he did in one game to Steve Young and to the 49ers. Unless you want to do that, you know, it is what it is. But Tom Brady's my number two guy. And, you know, don't forget, we got the new college football page popping off where we get the number one. Well, college sports page, S1210, college football's most wanted. The link is in the description. Please go ahead and subscribe and support the joint venture with the Cali Enigma and the Colossal Sports TV. And number one, he holding up number one, man. People say you a Lions fan. How you like Aaron Rodgers? I'm just a realist, man. And I understand the talent, and I understand he had nothing to work with Green Bay pretty much last year, you know. And this dude makes Green Bay go. Without him, they top five type of picking team. The mobility, the arm, and it's his time to be the best quarterback in the league. He's 34 years old. He ain't trying to wait out Tom Brady. I'm not saying that his overall achievements are better than Tom Brady's. I'm not saying that, but right now, I'm taking Aaron Rodgers as the best quarterback in the league. The accuracy, the arm. I mean, I've really never seen nobody flinging around like him. And like I said, I'm a realist, man. I'm not going to, you know, hate on him because he a rival. Like, I really don't, you know, don't have a hatred for the Packers. I have a hatred for the Bears. But, you know, Aaron Rodgers is my number one guy, man. Boy, it's the absolute truth. I mean, the mobility, the accuracy. Only thing that holding back is the injuries. And now they get older. That could be an issue. But that's my top five, you know. Aaron Rodgers, number one. Brady, number two. Walker, two, and Wentz, three. Russell Wilson, last name Wilson, number four. Number five, Drew Brees. Let me know your top five. Like I said, don't forget to check the link in the description to check the new college sports page we got with me, the Cali Enigma, and the Colossal Sports TV. Subscribe. Already dropped a little bit of content, but when the season heat up, it's going to get real. We on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, the Boston Clinic. Check the links in the description. All links this time, no usernames. And share. Hit the subscribe button and the bell icon button so you know we up live. Y'all know what it is. We gone.